body aarogyathin adayalam
out of the way out of the house go to the office they make sure that they carry some kind of a face wash especially for the oily skin you know you a face wash is a good product for oily skin and in combination an acne cream or if you have acne if you have growth of pimples or growth of any kind of acne that can also control it because all these products they work in tandem they work in combination noni as an active is there in all the products and these products they kind of reinforce each other if you're using a face wash or the talking about anti acne product here but a prerequisite to anti acne cream is also a face wash and if you see a face wash it comes with some mini capsules those mini capsules are having these noni actives and that when actives applied to the skin they are able to clean the top layer of the skin and the actives are also absorbed and they into the dermis level and they make the skin fresh it make the skin breathe out and after that when the skin is fresh and the pores have been cleaned then after that you can use an anti acne cream an anti acne cream gets absorbed the various kind of actives in anti acne cream is tea tree oil noni and garlic oil neem oil they get absorbed into the skin and with that the kind of effect you get is there's no outburst of more pimples no contamination of any kind of microbial and your skin is not looking very greasy and oily it looks very normal these are some reasons for why is the skin an oily skin now there could be endogenous factors endogenous is the inherent factors the genetic factors like hormonal aspects hormonal disturbances genetic aspects because of the genes transfer from parents to children then the exogenous factors the factors we have control on which is insufficient skin care if you're not washing our face very often if you're not taking care of the skin very well these are the exogenous factors smog and stress because we are stressed it does have an impact on our hormones our various kind of glands like when we are in stress it generally is a tendency of the sebaceous glands or the sebum producing glands that they tend to get more active and when we are stressed we the sebaceous glands give out more sebum more oil and the stressed out people have this tendency of having an oily skin and of course the sweat and the sun although we cannot avoid the sweat and the sun but we can take care that we can take care of the sweat and the sun by washing the skin more often by taking care of the skin more often so it's very important and it's a regime that whereby you have to wash your face very regularly if you have an oily skin and in combination with this face wash you can also recommend an anti acne cream for people who have oily skin so this is a combination what I'm going to come to the point is you know if you're promoting a product to a particular distributor or a particular customer of yours you can promote a package with the package you know this is a face wash this is the first step then step 2 is an anti acne cream and step 3 after that is a face pack and a scrub that all I have come to so it's a complete package where we can offer to a customer as a complete kit as a beauty regime kit so step 1 step 2 step 3 step 4 I come to that at the end of the session before I take you through all the products So all these reasons they lead to overproduction of sebum, which leads to oily skin. These are various actives: neem oil, tea tree oil, garlic oil. And we did this kind of an assessment on a 90-day treatment, and we had this cream which leads to an inhibition of DHT synthesis of 35%. There was a 46% decrease in severity of psoriatic skin condition after 90 days. And most people said that we want to buy this product because of the efficacy of the product. So ultimately this reduces the skin greasiness, improves the skin appearance, prevents skin irritation and leads to a smooth skin. So non-oily skin is a healthy, pleasant appearance skin. It's a natural source, it's a preservative free because the kind of actives that they're using like neem oil, tea tree oil, it's themselves are preservatives for the system and it's very easy to process. Moisturizing cream. Now, a moisturizing cream is as the name suggests, it moisturizes the skin. as you talked about an oily skin, as you talked about a normal skin, we also know about a dry skin. Now, dry skin is the one in which these sebaceous glands are not very active. So, the sebum which is produced from the skin is not sufficient to take care of the skin, because there is always a moisture loss from the skin surface, which is also called transepidermal water loss, which the body keeps on losing every time. As you are sitting now, your body is still losing moisture from the skin. So it is very important to provide the skin with moisture. Now that, if it is not being done by the sebaceous glands, is taken care by some external application products like a moisturizing cream. So if not, it's from the internal system. So from external system, we need to give the moisture. Now the moisturizing cream we have has a high quantity of vitamin E. It has almond oil, and with all these kind of systems, you know, it gives the skin the right kind of a texture, right kind of a shine and feel. It should not be too dry, because even dry skin leads to various kind of problems. Skin. Now, people who have sensitive skin, most of them, up to 50% of the consumers, they claim to have dry, itchy and sensitive skin. The requirement for an active ingredient. What kind of ingredient we need to have for such kind of dry skin, for which we want a moisturizing product like a moisturizing cream? They should avoid risk of irritation, because dry skin as such is very susceptible to irritation. So this kind of a system should be avoid any kind of irritation to the skin. It should strengthen barrier function. What does a barrier function mean? That it should strengthen any kind of water losses from the body outside, and it should be like a coat on top of the skin, that it is also providing moisture into the skin and also avoiding loss of moisture from the skin.